morning, students. The topic of today's module is agriculture marketing in India. Agricultural development has been considered to be an indicator of the quality of life at the grassroots level, making it what may be called the people's sector. In regard to the importance of agriculture in a broader socio-economic sense, all the three basic objectives of economic development of the country, namely output growth, price stability, and poverty alleviation, are best served by growth of agriculture sector. If public investment and market infrastructure in agriculture continued to be inadequate, there could be a serious problem of competitiveness and adequate supply response. No doubt, India is the larger producer of several agricultural products. In terms of quantity of production, India is the top producer in the world in milk and second largest producer in wheat and rice. We should therefore be concerned about improving quality while maintaining the lead in quantity. To benefit the farming community from the new global market access opportunities, the internal agriculture marketing system in the country also needs to be integrated and strengthened. In particular, the market system has to be revitalized to provide incentives to farmers to produce more, to convey the changing needs of the consumers to the producers, to enable production planning, to foster true competition among the market players, and to enhance the share of farmers in the ultimate price of its agricultural produce. Agriculture marketing. Agriculture marketing is defined as the study of entire gamut activities that direct the flow of goods and services from the primary producer to ultimate consumer. Agriculture is a production activity involving conversion of solar energy into palatable or usable form in harmony with nature. Agriculture marketing is the study of all the activities, agencies, and policies involved in the procurement of farm inputs by the farmer and the movement of agricultural products from the farmer to the consumers. It includes organization of agricultural raw material supply to processing industries, the assessment of demand for farm inputs and raw materials. Agricultural marketing plays an important role not only in stimulating production and consumption, but in accelerating the pace of economic development. Market classification. The word market comes from the Latin word mercatus, which means merchandise or trade, or a place where business is conducted. The market in economic sense refers not to a place but to a commodity or commodities, and buyers and sellers are in free intercourse with one another. Components of a market: for a market to exist, certain conditions must be satisfied. These conditions should be both necessary and sufficient. They may also be termed as the components of a market. The existence of a goods for transaction, physical existence, is however not necessary. The existence of buyers and sellers, trading operations between buyers and sellers, geographical demarcation of area such as place, region, country, or the whole world. The existence of a perfect competition of or uniform price is not necessary. Coming to classification of markets. Markets may be classified on the basis of dimensions like area, time, commodities, volume and competition. First one, on the basis of area from which buyers and sellers usually come from transaction, markets are local or village markets and regional markets. A market in which the buying and selling activities are confined among the buyers and sellers drawn from the same village or nearby villages. The village market exists mostly for perishable commodities. Regional markets, a market in which buyers and sellers for a commodity are drawn from a longer area than the local markets. Regional markets in India usually exist for food. National markets, a market in which buyers and sellers are at the national level. Next is the international market, a market in which the buyers and sellers are drawn from entire world. These are the biggest markets from the area point of view. These markets exist in commodities which have a worldwide demand and or supply, such as coffee, machinery, gold, silver, etc. The storage facility, transportation, preservation and processing techniques used can enhance the area dimension of market for a commodity. Example, milk can pasteurization enhances the area dimension from local to regional. Second one is the on the basis of time span. Markets on the basis of time span can be grouped as follows. Short period markets. The markets which are held only for a few hours are called short period markets. The products dealt with in these markets are of highly perishable nature, such as fish, vegetable, milk and flowers. Next is the long period markets. These markets are held for a longer time than the short period markets. The commodities traded in these markets are less perishable and can be stored for some time, for example, food grains and oil seeds. The prices are governed by both supply and demand forces. Next is the secular markets. These are markets of a permanent nature. The commodities traded in these markets are durable in nature and can be stored for many years. Example is market for machinery and manufactured goods. Next classification is based on commodity. It includes two aspects, number of commodities and nature of commodities. Number of commodities. A market may be general or specialized on the basis of the number of commodities in which transactions are completed. First one, general markets. A market in which all types of commodities such as food grains, oil seeds, fiber crops, etc. are bought and sold is known as general markets. These markets deal in a large number of commodities. Next is the specialized markets. A market in which transaction takes place only is one or two commodities are known as specialized market. For every group of commodities, separate markets exist. The example are food grain markets, vegetable markets, wool market and cotton market. Next is on the basis of nature of commodities. On the basis of the type of goods dealt in, markets may be classified into the following categories. Commodity markets, a market which deals in goods and raw materials such as wheat, barley, cotton, fertilizer seed, gold, etc. are formed as commodity markets. On the basis of volume of transaction, there are two types of markets. First one is the wholesale market. A wholesale market is one in which commodities are bought and sold in large lots or in bulk. Transaction in these markets take place mainly between traders. Next is the retail markets. A retail market is one in which commodities are brought and sold to the consumers as per their requirements. Transactions in these markets take place between retailers and consumers. The retailers purchase in wholesale markets and sell in small lots to the consumers. These markets are very near to the consumers. Role of government in promoting agriculture marketing. In the interest of public welfare, the government intervenes in the marketing system. The extent of intervention depends on the objectives of the government and the extent of defects and malpractices prevailing in the system. Government intervention may be direct or indirect, and it may take any one or combination of the following forms. Framing of rules and regulations for the protection of the interest of some sections of population. This may include restriction on activities of traders, licensing and market regulation. Promotional activities such as storage and warehousing, transportation and communication facilities, credit facilities, grading and standardization, and encouragement of cooperative marketing. Administration of prices at different levels of marketing, guaranteeing minimum support price to producers, providing commodities at fair prices to consumers, and fixing the rates of commissions charged by commission agents. Influencing supply and demand by import, export, internal procurement, and distribution. Market functionaries supervision. The officials of the market committee supervise the day-to-day functioning of regulated markets, that is, the secretary, auction clerks and other staff. The administrative decisions are taken by the nominated or elected market committee. The market committee consists of representatives of all sections, that is, farmers, traders, cooperative marketing societies, cooperative or commercial banks, autonomous bodies like Panchayat Samiti and Municipal Board of the area, and government officials. The number of former members is more than that of the other interest groups. The sources of funds to market committee for meeting administrative expenditure to create additional facilities in the market area are market fee, license fee or renewal fee and subsidy from the government. State agricultural marketing boards. These were established to supervise and provide guidance to market committees. The main functions of the board are to carry out the training of officers and staff, create facilities for grading and standardization, construct market road and approach road to the markets, construct market yard and sub-yard, establish and maintain the board office and others as specified. To tender advice to the government on the functioning of market committee and on improvement in agriculture marketing as and when referred to, and to frame bylaws help in the functioning of market committees and supervise their operations. COSAMB, that is Council of State Agriculture Marketing Board. The COSAMB, an apex body of the state marketing boards, was established in February 1988. The need for such a body was felt to coordinate the activities of state marketing boards, especially those connected with credit mobilization, central assistant for market development, and some common problems. Coming to cooperative markets. The efforts of the government to improve the marketing system of agricultural commodities have been only partially successful. The progress of regulated markets is not uniform in all areas. So, the establishment of cooperative marketing societies is another step taken to overcome the problems arising out of the present system of marketing agricultural produce. A cooperative sales association is a voluntary business organization established by its members' patrons to market farm products collectively for their direct benefit. It is governed by democratic principles, and savings are apportioned among members on the basis of their patronage. Agriculture marketing general features. Agriculture marketing system can be analyzed by looking at the farmers' marketing practices, marketing channels, and the structure of markets. The marketing system and farmers' marketing practices have undergone considerable changes during the last 50 years owing to the expansion of the size of the market, increased availability of infrastructure, and changes in the pattern of demand, and consequently introduction of new methods of processing, packaging, storage, and transportation. Farmers' marketing practices and evolution of marketing system are guided by the shelf life of the commodity. All agricultural products do not have the same shelf life. Some products are perishable, some are less, and some are even durable. Cotton and jute versus fruits, vegetables, and milk are the contrasting examples of agricultural products having long and short shelf life. In between these two extremes are other agricultural commodities, owing to the increase in marketed surplus and need to make these available in the off season and at place other than production points, functions of storage, processing, transportation, packaging, and grading are required to be performed either by the farmers or by the market functionaries. Coming to the main characteristics of marketing, optimization of input use and output produce. Agricultural marketing leads to an optimization of resources use and output management. An efficient marketing system can contribute to an increase in the marketable surplus by scaling down the losses arising out of the agriculture marketing inefficient processing, storage, and transportation. A well-designed system of marketing can effectively distribute the available stock of modern inputs and thereby sustain a faster rate of growth in the agricultural sector. Increase in farm income. An efficient marketing system guarantees to the farmers better prices for farm products and induce them to invest their surpluses in the purchase of modern inputs so that productivity may increase. This again results in increase in the marketed surplus and income of the farmers. Widening of markets. A well-known marketing system widens market for products by taking them to remote corners of the country to areas far away from the production point. Example, paddy produced in Punjab and Haryana are sold in remote tribal areas. Another example is potato. The widening of market helps in increasing the demand on a continuous basis and thereby guarantees a higher income to the producer. Growth of agro-based industries. The agriculture marketing system helps in the growth of agro-based industries and stimulates the overall development process of the economy. Many industries depend on agriculture for the supply of raw materials. Example, sugar industry, cotton industry, and silk industry. Price movements. An efficient marketing helps the farmers in planning their production in accordance with the need of the economy. This work is carried out through the price signals. Adoption and spread of new technology. The marketing system helps the farmers in the adoption of new scientific and technical knowledge. Employment. The marketing system provides employment to millions of people engaged in various activities such as packaging, transportation, storage and processing. Addition to national income, marketing activities add to the national gross national product. Better living, any plan of economic development that aims at diminishing the poverty of agriculture population, reducing consumer food prices, earning more foreign exchange or eliminating economic waste has to pay special attention to the development of an efficient marketing for food and agricultural products. Coming to benefits of efficient marketing. Any increase in efficiency of marketing process which result in lower cost of distribution and lower prices to consumers really brings about an increase in national income. A reduction in the cost of marketing is a direct benefit to the society. Marketing process brings new varieties, quality and beneficial goods to consumers. It provides connecting link between production and consumption. Approximately 1/3 of all persons gainfully employed in the country are engaged in the field of marketing, and about 1/4 of national income is earned by marketing profession. Scientific marketing has a stabilizing effect on the price level. If producers produce what consumers want and consumers have a wide choice of products, there are no frequent ups and downs in price. Marketing is a catalyst for the transmutation of latent resources into actual resources of desires into accomplishment and development of responsible economic leaders and informed economic citizens. Marketing brings to the farmers useful implements, tools and fertilizers, etc., and the benefits of the use of machines and free after sales service and make them modern farmers. Scientific marketing also remedies the imbalance in the supply of marketing available the surpluses to the defeat areas. If the functions of a marketing are not performed properly, the economic system may get out of balance, resulting in piling up of goods with retailers, wholesalers and manufacturers, which lead to closure of factories and retrenchment of workers. Thus, it plays an important role in the economic stability of a country, making marketing information services relevant to farmers. Accuracy, availability, applicability and analysis are the four A's of market information. If MIS are to have any meaning for farmers, the information they provide must be accurate and farmers must understand to which product, quality, etc. the prices refer. Further, even if prices are completely accurate, they are much use if they are only available to farmers too late for them to use effectively.